Welcome, guys, to the NFC Cup Round 3 with, in the north, Talisman playing as the Soviets. And in the south, we have Jesselyn playing as the Austria. Amazing sounds by Warren. Thank you, Warren. Yeah, that was a bit well. Okay, we're seeing a pretty basic start by Talisman, which we saw in the other game, which didn't crash but needed to be stopped with. But we're going to stop talking about that game. Again, two conscripts popping out for Talisman and for Jesselyn. Also an MG42 arriving on the field. And of course the Grenadiers. So Warren, what do we want to see this game?
Well, I personally want to see I was going to say PPSH conscripts, but then I realized that it was a guards commander. Well, I don't know. I'd be fine with partisans or Soviet industry.
Yeah, but it would be fun to see God Ravel. We haven't seen that commander being picked yet.
Oh, wait, no, they do have PPSHs. Never mind. I don't know why. I looked at it and I was like, oh, wait, they don't have PPSHs.
Sneaky move over here. Sorry, I'm disturbing you, but...
No, it's fine.
We have the MG popping into the building of the fuel of Talisman. Engineers managed to get out of range, but this is quite bad for Talisman. But Talisman is getting the fuel of Jesselyn, so it doesn't really matter. And yet we are going to see the same thing as last game. We have a support company over here for Talisman by the second engineers. And again, some nasty wire is going down by Jesselyn. It's really
gnarly
fun
wire you get there. Gnarly.
It's really fun to see the barbed wire battles. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's pretty strange. Both players left the mid for what it was and are moving now to the mid. Pretty late game, if you ask me. Oh, we are already 2.5 minutes in. We haven't seen anything on the mid.
Yeah. When you said barbed wire battle, I thought of like two people holding like pieces of barbed wire and attacking each other.
No. Who can barbed wire faster?
Yeah,
Soviet engineers or Austrian engineers?
Yeah. These Grens are okay. They're going to be walking in and negative cover. I thought the I guess the engineers would die even if they caught the Grens in negative cover.
It's a best of three. Continue. Sorry.
There's some contesting on the cutoff of Jesselyn.
Yeah. So good decision from Talisman, because the fuel of Jesselyn is now totally cut off and the munition. And Jesselyn's also under a treat, so it doesn't look like he's getting it back very early. Although this MG is
that's a nice positioning of the MG. If he keeps making sure that MG is in the right place, I think he's just fine.
Yeah, I agree. Just going to pause it real quick. Sorry, guys. Going to adjust my settings in OBS because I'm lagging a bit and I want it to go smooth. Just going to change it real quickly. Let me change this one over here. Gonna restart the brackets real quick. And best of 3A. So we are back. Probably not lagging much anymore, hopefully. Okay, we are going to continue, guys. There we go. So we have Flamer engineers moving into the mid. Maxim have set up in the mid in the building. Pretty important building. We haven't seen a mortar yet from Jesselyn. That's pretty strange. I would think we would... Well, it would be a good decision to make the mortar.
We get some flames going down here.
Yeah, Grenadiers.
Yeah, those Grenadiers are gonna need a retreat at some point. Pretty soon.
Oh yeah, come on! You should retreat, Jesselyn. Not smart to stay over there. Yeah, there we go.
No, I think he got his timing right. He's definitely stalling. Yeah, like look at these Grenadiers behind.
I didn't saw that.
Just the amount of time that he needed to stay there before retreating.
Yeah, but the Grenadiers aren't doing much damage to the Maxim. And there we go, a second Maxim has been built. We have... Oh no, that's not true. Yeah, there we go, Grenadiers retreat. Good decision. We weren't going
to win
that battle.
I think that was the most underwhelming flank I've ever seen. Sorry.
I agree. I totally agree.
Oh man, I don't know if oh that's what he was doing. I'm stupid. He was making sure that he was trying to get his cutoff back.
Oh well, that is pretty fun. We are seeing Jesse moving up right now. Yeah, he's getting his. Oh, he still has the heavy cover. That's really nice. He's getting his cutoff back. That's really important because he isn't getting any fuel or munition at the moment, although he is keeping his fuel back. But we see a very big difference between the fuel of Talisman and Jesselyn. Look at that. 120 fuel against 100 fuel, I'm sorry. That's pretty strange. Maxim is moving right into Flinger Pioneers. Oh, but he spotted it. Good. Very nice play over there from Talisman. Oh yeah, and there we go. We have our mortar that's going to bump the Maxim out of the mid.
There we go.
Some interesting battles over here. Another conscript is coming from Talisman. Interesting again.
Yeah.
It's nice that Talisman is really pushing the cutoff point of Jesselyn and the fuel.
Yeah, and the MGs are definitely well positioned. I think those two houses can, if they're really good for MGs, but not that good for normal infantry.
Yeah, but since or something like that.
Since you only need that one in window to stick out an MG, they're really good for that.
Yeah, we see this mortar firing. Oh, he's firing at the mid, actually. Oh, this MG needs to watch out. She get out of there. Do we have healing already? Yes, we have healing already. And, well, Jesselyn doesn't have healing because he has been cut off of his munition all the time. So he just doesn't have the munition yet to make one.
Yeah. Well, I don't think he wants to because he could have. But he's investing in other things. Like Flamer Pioneers.
Yeah. He is getting his cutoff point back right now, so that's really good. That's the one thing he needs to get back in this game. Engineer's pretty low on health, and yeah, they're going to retreat. Good decision. We've got a mortar coming from Talisman, actually, right now. Probably trying to counter that mortar of Jesselyn, so he can get in buildings again without being bombed the hell out of it.
And yeah, this is a surprisingly good map for mortars.
Yeah,
I mean, like,
yeah, I agree. Pretty interesting. Oh, this is fun. Oh yeah, there we go. Maxim isn't on time to get in this building. German MG can sprint faster than Maxim's a little. And there we go. First scout car has arrived from Jesselyn. Nice skin over there.
Mm-hmm.
What is this thing going to cost? Do we have... We don't have anti-tank grenades yet.
Yeah, we're gonna see this increased armor and decreased damage in action. Look at that amazing low damage.
Yeah, but he is retreating his conscript, both of them. I don't know why you would do that, because I think they've could have caused a bit of damage.
And this would be really cool if he had a mine. Oh no, Jesselyn would. Okay, if there was a mine right there between the two cobblestone
things. Yeah, now
things.
He can just rush into the base, although that's not a good decision if you would ask me. And you see that he's pulling a little bit back. He's trying to deal some damage to this mortar, but it's not doing much damage at the moment.
Yeah, this is an underwhelming amount of damage.
Yeah,
I mean,
but
like,
it's a good decision probably to stay over there because you can see that he's capping the whole map back.
Yeah, definitely.
A minute ago he didn't have any map control at all, and now he has almost the whole map. And, well, this scout car actually has been a pretty good investment if he did it just for that. But there we go, he's trying. Oh yeah, AT grenade is probably going down, there we go.
Yep.
Scout car almost down, but it's going to retreat. Sorry for the lag, guys, a little bit lagging still, but...
Yeah, that would have died if it was the old
Scout car, yeah.
A scout car, but then again, it would have killed more if it was the old scout
car. Yeah. Also, not, also
I like.
True.
I want the old scout car back.
Well,
just like
S-lines
boring.
It's on the right of the middle VP. Well, it's not boring. It's something else.
Well, it feels inert. It feels inert, though. It's like.
Well,
it
doesn't... it's not. It's not as effective against infantry anymore. But if you have three scout cars against the T-70, I know one is going to win.
And okay, so. Yep. So everyone knows that the scout car was prized for its anti-tank ability.
Hey, this is fun. Talisman has two engineers with flamer upgrades. Is this a misclick or did he do this on purpose? Because he doesn't have any minesweepers. And that's pretty, well, pretty bad because you can see these S-mines in the middle VP. And now he needs something else to remove these. And tier 3 is just going down for... Talisman, but we also have the Panzergrenadiers coming for Jesselyn.
Yeah,
but he hasn't.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't have enough munition to make Panzerschreck, so maybe an early, well, pretty late T-70 actually could do some good damage against that scout car.
Mm-hmm.
Going to see.
Definitely.
Grenadiers. Oh, grenade coming in. Oh, that was pretty nice. A little bit late reaction over there. Nice retreat.
Mm-hmm.
That was a nice grenade. Oh, flamer engineers are coming in. Probably going to push out this grenadier squad, especially now it's
yeah. Well, the scout car is coming in. Oh, I guess it was too late. I guess he could have tried to go even onto negative cover to negate the flamer damage.
Yeah, there we go. He's fat one with only 3 kills. That's not much.
I don't look. He's missing. The scout car is missing every shot.
It's pretty sad, and we have the T-70 incoming, so, well, this is going to be interesting, a T-70 against a scout car, I haven't seen that one in 1v1 yet, one scout car versus one T-70, this is going to be fun, and probably a pack is coming for Jesselyn, I think, Panzergrenadier has also arrived on the field, and Industry has been chosen by Talisman, that means that he can call in extra fuel, and I think he's going to do that.
This is cool in the center. He's getting in mortars. Well, it's not cool anymore, but he has an MG to cover his mortars. Unfortunately, that's not going to work too well for him since he's getting scout car. Well, if the scout car manages to do any damage, look at this damage, man.
It's pretty
look
sad.
At it. It's so sad.
Needs to watch out.
This is the saddest damage I've ever seen.
Yeah, but engineers are also there, and now, yeah, there we go, models are dropping, so he should get out of there. Pretty good decision over there. Back
yeah.
is coming, T-70 is moving in, just going to pause it because I'm lagging a lot and I don't like it.
I bet what Jesselyn is thinking right now is like, what is this? Why is my scout car doing no damage?
Well, I think he played with the new patch.
Well, yeah, I think definitely, but I don't know. If he hasn't played his German yet.
Oh, Grenadiers are flanking this Maxim. Oh, but they're going to stand over there. Rifle grenade incoming. Yeah, there we go. Pretty low health, Maxim. Oh, needs to retreat because it's pretty low on health. Should get out of there, Maxim.
Well, no, he suppressed the guys. So
that's really nice.
So
they're
he
not
can
doing
win.
Damage. Do you see this? The 70 shots doesn't do much damage against the scout car. Wow.
I just bug splatted.
You bug splatted?
Bug splatted. Whoa.
FPS are dropping. This is strange. This is strange.
Oh, by the way, guess who changed their Steam name to Pussy Destroyer for the competition?
Barton PL.
Yeah. Yep. You got it.
I saw it, yeah. Well, I think it's on. It's your internet that's dropping Spud Crawley because I haven't had any dropped frames yet, according to OBS. And we are on 40 FPS, so should be really good, actually. Oh, yeah, there we go. Joran has left the game. If you don't mind, I'm just going to keep casting this one without you then.
Okay, see ya. Sorry about that.
Yeah, doesn't matter.
I'll mute myself and come back when you're ready.
Okay. Well, I'm just going to hang up, I think. That's better.
Okay, see ya.
Yep. So guys, maybe the stream will be better right now. So guys, here we go. We are getting back in the game right now. Yeah, there we go. T-70 is moving in on the scout car, and well, scout car isn't doing any damage to the T-70, but T-70 isn't doing much damage against this scout car either. And we've got the pack moving in, and we've got no more lag. Yeah, there we go. Conscript, stop building this sandbag. Pretty good decision. Need retreat knight now through the grenadiers. Oh, this grenadier is actually getting pretty low on health. Should watch out for this flame engineer squad. Are we going to see a grenade coming in? Oh, pretty heavy battle. No, yeah. Good decision to retreat over there. Just good play, good play. We haven't seen the allied supply drop yet. I'm surprised. T-70 and scout car are getting repaired. This is nice. He knows that he shouldn't be going into this building with the two mortars on the field, so he's just going to cover that building with his Maxim. Scout car moving in again, doing no damage at all. T-70 is going to try to get that scout car. Needs to watch out for an AT grenade, but MG is doing his work. Are we going to see a... Nope, we aren't going to see armored piercing rounds because the T-70 is there. Scout car needs to watch out. Etigan is in a pretty bad position over there. Oh, maybe he could get one shot. No, it can't. Needs to get out of there. And in the meantime, Jesseline got the cutoff point of Talisman. That's interesting. Interesting. It's a VAT 1 T-70. Nice work over there. Another engineer squad incoming. That means that Talisman has lost an engineer squad with flamers. I missed that. Sorry. Is he going to upgrade this one with the minesweepers? Curious about that one. Grenadiers are going into the building. Probably going to... Yeah, there we go. Hop out again. And if you look at the victory points, they're pretty equal at the moment. Let's have a look at upgrades. Oh, tier 2 has been... Yeah, well, they're in a pretty equal battle right now. This is going to be interesting. Are you going to see a long game on Fame Field approach between Jesselyn and Talisman, guys? Get hyped. Engineers against these Grenadiers. And Engineers are again losing, so they are going to retreat. Panzer Grenadiers shouldn't move in. Oh, they are getting supported by the pack. Didn't notice that. Yeah, there we go. Flamethrower has been picked up by Jesselyn's Grenadiers, and Minesweepers, as I said, have gone online for the Engineers. Pretty good decision, because he needs to clear this S-mine field. Oh yeah, straight away he's repairing because the PAC-40 took a shot on the T-70. Good decision, because he now needs two more shots to kill it. And these shots aren't going to come over here. And Jesselyn actually picked joint operations. Interesting. Are we going to see RT or maybe a PAC-40? I am curious. Oh, and the SU-76 is going to be made. And we don't have much to count it. Oh, T-70 is going down probably. Only needs one more shot. Can the scout car do it? And yes, he can. Or did this? No. Oh yeah, the scout car actually killed the T-70. Nice pickup over there by Jesselyn. That's a heavy loss for Talisman. That T-70 was doing a great job. Mortar Fajar. 11 kills for the mortar of Jesselyn and 1-0. So the mortar of Jesselyn has been a good choice, but the mortars of Talisman haven't done much. Mines are going down over here by Talisman, but they are going to get flanked by Grenadiers. Did he see it? Yes, he did. And now he's going to blow up this mine, probably. Yeah, there we go. 30 munition wasted by Talisman. Big push coming in from Jesselyn. This mortar needs to retreat. Yes, there we go. Maxim is in a pretty weird position over there. Just going to take a sip of my game drink, guys. Sorry. SU-76 is moving up, probably going to bombard this. Yeah, there we go, he's bombarding the fat two Panzer Grenadiers. And oh, this is nice. He laid a S minefield over there and positions his MG So he can't sweep the minefield yet, although he needs to watch out for a flank of this conscript and this MG. I think he should retreat. That would be a good decision. He's just going. Desmond is doing a good job of letting these engineers over there. Oh, Pack 40 is getting a shot off on this SU-76, but needs to back up right now because Talisman is probably going to move up over here. A lot of S minefields by Jessamyn. That's fun. Oh! And SU-76, look at the damage. The SU-76 got a shot off on the scout car, but it didn't. Well, it did do so. Well, it was not much damage that it did. Grenadiers are moving out of here. The middle VP is a little bit bouncing around between Talisman and Jessamyn. And I think we are going to see some kind of heavy manpower. Well, we are going to see RT or Pack 40. Sorry for my English, guys. I'm so sorry. MG needs to watch out. Vetri Mortar. This is a really nice one. It has been really nice for Jessamyn. Good decision to build that one. And Talisman just got his munition back. Both players are getting their munition back. We are seeing a lot of mines by Jessamyn and almost no mines by Talisman. This is interesting. And yet, there we go. We've got the artillery, the German artillery coming down for Jessamyn. This is nice. He's probably going to try to get rid of these mortars. Building over here pretty low on health. Here we're going to see Panzerfaust. No, we aren't. MG is setting up and insta retreat over there. By the way, nice. This guy is Vetri already. Really nice, really nice. Well, at the moment there's not happening much. I think Talisman is saving for a KV2. And there we go. Engineers should retreat over there. Recon has been called in by Jessamyn. He's going to scout for his RT that can almost fire, I think. Yeah, it's almost finished. There we go. Well, the fuel, well, nothing pretty interesting. Jessamyn has more fuel, of course, but I think... No, we haven't seen... Did he upgrade it already? No, he didn't upgrade to Battle Phase 3 yet. Artillery is firing. Where is it firing? There we go. Direct hit on the mortar. Wow, squad wipe. An insta squad wipe for that artillery. Wow, that's unlucky for Talisman. Really nice to see Jessamyn use this reconnaissance overflight in combination with that howitzer. Pretty nice. No AT grenade coming in on this Vetri scout car. KV-8 has been called in by Talisman. This is interesting. Big push incoming from Jessamyn. SU-76 needs to watch out for AT grenades. Panzer grenadiers haven't been upgraded with the Shreks out. Oh, I'm just saying it, and it's happening. That's really nice. Sprint ability has been used by Talisman. Nice work. He gets out of there in time, and the KV-8 can deal some good damage over there. Back is bouncing. Lol. We have a Stuke incoming, guys. Wow. Interesting. If this isn't Nomada, I don't know what Nomada is. MG Maxim is going in for the flank. Oh, and the Panzer Grenadiers need to retreat just when their Panzer Strax pops out. So Talisman now knows that he has the Panzer Grenadiers with the Strax. Why is the MG, I was just saying, why is the MG not firing on this Maxim? Pretty strange. MG needs to get out there. KV-8 is moving in. Peck is repositioning. We almost have a Stuke on the field. Is he going for this Vetri mortar, or is he going straight away for this artillery? No, good decision. He's going for the mortar. It's not doing much damage. Needs to watch out. Oh, Lelik pathfinding over there. Pack 40 is getting a lot of shots off over there. Stuke is coming in. Do it. Where's the SU-76? It's bombarding the pack at the moment. You should go for the Stuke. Yeah, there we go. Stuke is going to fire at the SU-76. Pack fired on the SU-76 too. This SU-76 is down. It's abandoned. Wow, that's unlucky or lucky for Talisman. I don't know what it is. You guys can decide. This is interesting. Maxim needs to watch out because he's probably going to get wrecked by some grenadiers and a mort, of course. Why is the scout car not moving him? Maybe because he's not doing much damage, but Stuk has an heavy engine damage. Needs to get out of there. Oh, Maxim, mortar is firing and it misses. Oh yeah, there we go. The SU-76 has been recruited. Oh my god. There we go. The scout car is moving in. It's doing a lot of damage. And it's down. Oh, that's so sad for Talisman. Heavy loss over there. Now he has almost no AT except for this AT gun. But can he get this scout car in? Yes, a trade. Oh my god, he's not doing damage at all. This, oh, it's a bandit. That's so sad. We have more artillery coming in at the moment. Did he get another mortar? I think he got some more kills, but oh, he finished the scout car off. Nice job over there by Talisman, but he lost his T-70 and his SU-76. KV-8 is probably looking to go down right now. One more shot. The gun is firing. Stuk is going out, getting out of there. That's a good decision. Flamethrower has been dropped by Talisman, I think. This is nice. Nice play over here. How much kill does the RTS? 6 kills. Oh, well, it did get one squad wipe. That was pretty nice. The first hit was the best hit, probably. More reconnaissance is coming in for this howitzer. He's using the reconnaissance so the howitzer can get a better accuracy. Grenadiers need to watch out. Fat 3 over here. That was a howitzer hit. No, that was a mortar hit. Howitzer is firing again. Where is it firing? It's firing at the conscripts. Another good hit over there. More hits are coming in. No, that one didn't hit. Fat 2 Panzer Grenadiers are suppressed over here. He's going to, Jesselyn is going to sweep this minefield. Oh no, it's never mind. My fault. Maxim has been lost. Did the artillery do that? Yes, it did. Wow, KV-8 is still on the field, but it's getting repaired. Needs to help his AT gun out. And yeah, there we go. A retreat is coming in from Jesselyn. And this Maxim shooter, yeah, there we go. We can see that Talisman is probably saving for KV-2, I think. Good decision. Could be a really nice squad, well, tank for this map. Jesselyn is in a pretty good spot right now. I don't know why Talisman isn't using the allied supply drop. He's floating a lot of munition and he can use some fuel. Why don't you use allied supply drop, Talisman? Etigan, watch out. KV-8 has just been... has just been promoted to Fat 1. Stuk is going after this because the Etigan is repositioning in a... Oh, because the Etigan is down. Oh, why aren't we seeing the Etigan grenade? Why aren't you using your munition, Talisman? I don't get it. Grenadiers should get out of there too. And in the meantime, Jesselyn is going for the triple cap. That's a good idea. Oh, engineers. Yeah, there we go. Retreat and... Let's have a look how much kills. 15 kills, almost Fat 1. Another arty strike is going down. Oh, on the engineers. And Talisman is moving straight away. Good decision over there. This is really nice Normala by Jesselyn. Really nice to see. Really nice to see. Jesselyn is getting the triple cap. If he can... Oh, yes. Oh, he managed to... Make sure that Talisman couldn't cap the right VP just in time. He just went in the circle before the conscripts could finish the neutralization cap. We have the mortar doing, I don't know what he's doing. Yeah, artillery is Fat 1 right now. 20 kills already, really nice. He can just bombard the base. Another Maxim is down by a nice light artillery strike. That's nice. Jesselyn is using his commander in a really good way. This is really nice to see. Because you don't see joint operation very often. Stuk has just been promoted to Fat 2. Etigan is firing, so he should get out of there. KV-8. KV-8 is moving forward again. We have one Etigan on the... Well, we had two Etigans, but the Etigan got... Finished by the Panzergrenadiers. Panzergrenadiers are hunting this on this KV-8. Maxim is... Oh yeah, there we go, the retreat is coming in, good decision. And in the meantime, Talisman is going to try to get the right VP back. Wow, this is a good battle. We have a Fat 2 streak over here, all with only one kill, one infantry kill. LOL. Need double arty fire. Yeah, should he make another arty? Well, how is it called? Another German howitzer. I'm just going to call it the German howitzer. I don't know. It's a pretty... He's going to lose a lot of manpower because of that. And, well, he's probably going to need to make some kind of tanks. He still didn't upgrade to tier 4, so... I think you should do that first. Talisman is in a pretty bad position at the moment. In the mid, he is really pushed back. Oh, Grenadier squad should watch out. Is it going down by the conscripts? Oh... It's going to survive, I think. Arty is coming down. Where is it coming down? On the AT again, it's not doing much. You should use the reconnaissance overflight again. Sorry. Fat 3 bounce grenadiers. Look at these motherfuckers over here. Really nice to see. We've got a P4 incoming for Jesselyn. Is this a good choice, guys? Is this a good choice? I don't know. Oh man, look at these repair stations. A lot of repair stations. You can almost call in the KV2, so this is going to be fun, guys. Although, if the KV2 gets in the mobile ability, you know that he can fire more, but he can't move. The howitzer can just fire at the KV2. I don't know how much damage it does, but... we're going to see. In the meantime, Jesselyn is capping the fuel of Talisman. That means no fuel for Talisman right now. P4 has just arrived. Look at it, the bastard. There we go. He's going to hunt for some conscripts on the right. Oh, Fat 3 Grenadier squads. Conscripts, why are you not... Oh, he's going to retreat. Wow, that's... Grenadier squad. It's pretty lucky. I don't know what the P4 was doing over there, but is the howitzer is firing again on the mortar, the recruit mortar. Smoke is coming in to cover this conscript squad. Etigan is going to... Oh, we've got a base rush coming in front with the P4. What is he going to do? Why are you here? It's dangerous. P4. KV2 has just been called in. Oh, I missed that one. First shot missed, probably. KV2 is moving in again. Oh, Arty is doing such a good job with keeping Talisman in his base. This is really nice, guys. Although I think Jesselyn should try to get the left to get a triple cap right now. KV2 is firing at these engineers. VAT2 engineers just managed to escape. He got his first 3 kills over there. And, well, RT has 21 kills. Leichte Feldhaubitze. I did it. Yeah, enough. I did it. Not going to forget that one. Yeah, there we go. KV2 is in mobile mode. Well, it's going to be interesting to see how big the range is of this KV2 right now. Can he maybe shoot at this MG? No, he can't. Nice smoke coming in. Good play over there. MG can't fire. We are going to see more Archie incoming, probably. And, wow, look at these Vetsuri motherfuckers. Grenadiers and Panzer Grenadiers. Going to fight these engineers, and I can tell you that these engineers are going to lose this fight. Yeah, there we go. Retreat is coming in. KV8 is firing at these engineers, and for the rest, well, not much interesting. And more reconnaissance is coming in. That means that we can see Arty. Where is the Arty coming? Come on. Is he firing at his base? Yes, he is trying to destroy these repair stations. Wow, that's interesting. KV2 is going to flank. Gets a good hit on this Stuk. Needs to watch out. Stuk needs to watch out. Ategan was also firing pretty low on health right now. Where's the P4? P4's on the right. Should move in. Peck is moving. KV8 is also moving in. Trying to get these mortars and MGs. Peck 40 bounces. P4 is coming in right now. KV2, what are you doing? Get some shots off on this mortar. No, Vet2, by the way. The RT has just been promoted to Vet2. Really nice. KV8 is firing at these mortars. Oh, is this mortar going to get out of there? Oh, no, it doesn't. A heavy loss for Jesselyn over there. Vet3 mortar. Oh, yeah, of course. I forgot. Vet3 is Vet0, but Vet0, but it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. It looks really nice, and they sometimes get abilities from Vet. Oh, conscripts. Vet3 conscripts are going down probably. Oh, the side blocker saves them. That is lucky for Talisman over here. Although this Maxim needs to get out of there too. KV2 is, well, KV2 has just been bouncing around all over the map right now. And it's missing almost all his shots, and we are seeing Jesselyn saving up for something else. Oh, guys. Was that a wipe? Yes, that was a wipe. Oh my god, Vet3 Panzergrenadiers with Shrex just went down. Another heavy loss for Jesselyn this time. Pack 40 is being built over here, but KV8 is moving in for the flank. We need to watch out, though. Always firing at the... KV2 is also coming in. Is this pack going down? It needs to cancel that pack. Vet2 KV8 is... Oh, it's down. That's a heavy loss. He needs to call in another one. That KV2 was doing a really great job. Oh, P4 is going to escape probably. And he's finishing the pack 40. Wow. That was a really nice play by Jesselyn over there. He managed to defend his pack 40 and get the KV2 down. Wow. And finally we are seeing Allied Supply drop. I feel like he should have done that way earlier. Pretty weird pack 43 positioning over there. KV2. Oh, are we seeing the RT going down? RT is going down again. I think we had another loss over here with flamethrower engineers. Talisman is being pushed back really far in the base. KV2 is moving in, although over here. Oh, nice shot on the grenadiers. Stuk is trying. It's almost Vet1, by the way. Then he gets the capping ability. Stuk, what are you doing, Stuk? Should do more. Vet2 is not enough. We need you to be Vet3. Oh, look at this range of this pack 40. It can't hit the mobile KV2 right now, but wow. It's really nice to have some kind of backup over here. Oh, conscripts. I think that was a friendly kill, maybe? Yeah, friendly kill one. Stuk needs to watch out, though. Another Ategan shot over there, but it's going to get out of there. Oh, man, that AT grenade went in pretty far. More Ategans are being built by Talisman. I don't know if that is the right decision with the... what was it? I don't know. The German artillery on 31 kills over here. Destroyed almost all the repair stations. Wow, Jesselyn is using this commander in a really good way. We haven't seen this commander being used that much in if 1v1, so this is really nice. The only thing is that he's floating a lot of fuel, but I guess he doesn't need much tanks at the moment. But I think he should get something to get rid of this KV2. Oh, there we go. First shot hit the rear armor of the KV2. This is interesting. It's said that Talisman can't finish these Stuk and Panzer IV off all the time. There we go. And more shots are coming in on the KV2. He's getting out of mobile defense, I think. Good decision. He's already on half of his health. Wow. Still no upgrade to tier 4. MG is moving in. I think we are going to see rifle grenades. Yeah, there we go. One rifle grenade. Wow, a lot of health drops down, but he managed to pin these squads down so they can't do any more damage. That's really nice, but of course he needs to retreat. Where are the minesweepers of Talisman? He should move them to the right. Yeah, there you go. Because this S mine needs to be cleared. Come on, Talisman. We want to see a comeback. Oh, second P4 coming. So he isn't going for the tier 4. That is interesting. More reconnaissance is going in. That means that the howitzer is going to fire again. But on what? Is he going to fire at the cave 2? Or should he fire at this AT gun and mortar? Talisman is getting some map control back, as you can see right in the corner over here. You can see that he's getting map control back. That's really nice. I think Jesselyn should make something to defend this back a little bit more. I think it's it's really vulnerable right now. Where's the KV2? KV2 is moving in. I really thought that I heard it. Oh, we've got a target weak point coming in. Oh, he didn't get the shot off. That's sad. KV2 is going to get flanked by the Stu probably. Needs to watch out, but AT guns are helping him right now, but they're not firing. And oh, by the way, Jesselyn should do something about this, fishing blocker. I don't know what he can do about it. I don't know if he can crush it, but that doesn't really matter. Oh, and we have P4s coming in for the flank right now, trying to get rid of this AT guns, I'm sorry. KV2 in a pretty bad position. Oh, P4 is coming down probably. One more shot. It needs one more shot. There we go. It's down. Where's the Stuk? Stuk is firing at KV2. KV2 needs to watch out. Why aren't we seeing any conscripts over here? Etigan is going down. KV2 gets a... target weak point coming in on this KV2. Only one more shot. Oh, it's a bandit. Again, a bandit vehicle. So much abandoned vehicles right now. More Etigans are moving in. Is this P4 also going down? Fat2 Etigan is down. Stuk is trying to get this KV2. Trying to kill this KV2. Artie is firing on the mortar, who is firing smoke at the KV2. Oh wow, squad wipe on the mortar from the artillery Fat3 right now. 37 kills, really nice. And there we go, KV2 is down by Fat3 Stuk. Wow, that's really nice. P4 should watch out. One more shot is needed. Can he get a AT grenade off? No, he can't. Can he get this AT gun in time to get some shots off? I don't think so. Oh man. Well, Talisman lost one. Jesselyn lost one P4. Oh man, that's sad. But he killed these KV2 and a mortar with his RT. But there we go. Another KV2 has been called in by Talisman. And Jesselyn actually needs to think about the VPs right now, because he only has 200 VP points remaining. By the way, guys, if there's something wrong with the audio, please say it. And this is interesting. A Ostwind has been called in. Being built right now. And wow, look at this battlefield. Look at this battlefield. Everything is destroyed in this area by the RT, the Fat3 RT, that has 38 kills right now. P4 and the Stuk are getting repaired. More repair stations over here, but they are getting bombed by Jesselyn's RT. This is really nice. KV2 is in mobile oh no, it just went out of the mobile mode. And I think Jesselyn should have gone to the left victory point earlier in the game to get the VPs of Talisman down quicker. And we have more reconnaissance incoming. And there we go, another repair station is down. I don't know how much repair station did he kill. He already killed 4 repair stations. Nice work by Jesselyn. Oh, wow, back 40 gets some shot off. Back 43 on the KV2. One more shot was needed, but he managed to escape. Talisman managed to escape. Here we go, the Ostwind is over here. This is going to be interesting, guys. He's going to try to defend this middle VP with some more mobile shit. Well, it's moving to the right right now. Maxim, yeah, there we go. He already saw the Ostwind. Maxim is retreating. Good decision over there. And conscripts are retreating too. Maybe you should have thrown a T grenade first. because now he can just chase these conscripts, although he's not doing it. Pack 43 needs some repairs too. Stuk is moving in, the veteran Stuk, really nice Stuk over there. KV2 is moving to the right to get this Oswin. Wow, nice damage over there. Etigen is probably going to get flanked over here by the Stuk. KV2 is already on half of his health. Target weak point comes in. Pack 43 gets a shot off. So, oh, the Stuk bounces. Wow, that's unlucky for Jesselyn. That's really unlucky. I don't know what this week. He captured the point, and Jesselyn is going for the fuel of Talisman right now. That's nice. Now Talisman isn't getting any fuel anymore, and he is struggling with repairing his KV2, especially with this Artie over here on 50 kills. Wow. And the Pack 43 is on V1-2 right now, so that means that he can use target weak point just like the Stuk did against this. Well, what? Target weak point for the Pack 43 is 30 munitions, and for the Stuk is 35 munitions. Where's the Etigen? And for the Etigen, it's 30 munitions as well. Lol. P4 is moving in. Hasn't done. Oh well, already 10 kills, never mind. Etigen is firing in. We've got an AT grenade incoming. That means engine destroyed. But Oswind is moving in to save his buddy, the P4. Etigen is getting flanked. Needs to watch out over here. The RT is in the meantime firing at the base buildings of Talisman. And Jesselyn, listen to me. He kept the left, so we have a triple cap right now. And I don't know how Jesselyn is going to get back from this. Wow. Maxim is getting flamed. Can he suppress this guy? Oh, I don't think he can. And there we go. A rifle grenade, I'm sorry, has been called in. Oh yes, he can suppress actually. He's shooting out of his range. There we go, the retreat has been pulled off by Talisman. Nice work. Whoa, look at these bilge buildings. Oh man, support company is actually pretty low on health right now. That means that he can't call in more Etigens if it gets destroyed. Also, this option actually has been a pretty good choice if you ask me. It defends this Pack 43 and this Pack 40 really nice. What can Talisman do right now? He's totally base pinned at the moment. Another repair station is going down. I don't know why he made so much repair stations, because almost all of them got destroyed by this nice artillery over here, and he knew that that artillery was over there. I think he should have called in more LSI drops early in the game. Well, look at the veterancy of Jesselyn right here. Really nice. You can see that he has a really nice, army preservation. Well, sorry guys for my English. KV2 is moving in, is going to try to flank this back 40, I think. Is Jesselyn aware of this? Yes, he is. He's moving right now. He's moving his pack. That's really nice. He is paying attention. Stuk can't see the KV2 actually. Well, more RT is being called in. Where? I think on the Etigen over there. And this Etigen is going down. And KV2 is moving in, but it's probably too late right now. Although he is managed to cap the right VP. That is fun. So, oh, Panzerfaust has been called in. That means that the KV2 is even more slower than he already is. Oh, direct hit from the RT. Etigen is down. Wow, this RT, man. It destroys the Etigen. This RT has been great. Tree just flying around the air. What? Did you saw the shadow of the tree? Lol. This spot on bra. Oh, thank you. 60 kills already. Nice. Yeah, and this is probably GG for Talisman. This is probably GG. P4 conscripts are trying to do something, but it's just too late. It's GG. Talisman, accept it and go to game 2. Wow, look at the holy float of Jezzlyn, 600 fuel. I've never seen 600 fuel being floated in a 1v1 game. And Talisman knows this is the end, because he has a lot of manpower and he's doing nothing with it. He's just going to try to get some more VPs down on Jezzlyn. I'm sorry. KV2 is firing at the P4, not doing much damage. Where's the PAC-40? PAC-40 is it's out of the range of the PAC-40, the KV2 at the moment. And one last push of Talisman, but the Arty is firing on the AT again. Oh, almost another direct hit. Stuk needs to watch out for this AT again. And the conscripts, of course. Yeah, there we go. Conscripts are moving in through this minefield. Oh, they're probably going for the right VP, of course. Yeah. KV2 is flanking. PAC-40 is probably going to reposition. Is he going to use target weak point, the PAC-40? Yes, there we go, target weak point. Stuk is moving in, and then I think, yeah, there we go. Talisman surrendered. Wow, guys. GG, well played.